this step, we will take a snapshot of the area at the start of the period. Only in the next step will we think about the future. For the moment, let's talk about the present. What you see here is the land use bar. It's a schematic representation of our area. We see its name, Blue River Basin, and its size, 100,000 hectares, as we entered them at step one. For the moment, our land use bar is empty. We will fill it with different land uses using the different icons that are just above it. Before we start, let's take a little time to think it through. You will not need to describe all of the types of vegetation and crops present in the area in detail. What's important is to define the few land uses that matter to the actors in the planning process. Which crop or crops will be discussed? What land use choices could be made in the future? In our Blue River Basin, for example, at step one, we mentioned that various actors are competing to use large portions of forests. Positions are polarised over the arrival of foreign investors who want to develop large oil palm plantations. It will be important in this case to first describe the forests and oil palm plantations, and then the other land uses that the planning process could affect. We advise you to use up to 12 different land uses, and to overlook areas that are not at stake in your land use planning. For example, zones covered by lakes, deserts or cities and villages. Let's start with our forest uses. It's best if you can have a recent land use map of the area at hand to estimate the extent of each use. These maps are also a good basis for discussion with different groups. For our example, the map allows us to distinguish among forest categories: protected forests, logged over forests, and community forests. We also see that the largest forest use is the forest concession. In the land use planner, we first drag the icon forest to the land use bar and start defining this forest concession. We give it a name and enter its size as estimated from our map, 30,000 hectares. You can see that two sections called ecology and economy appear. These boxes will enable you to enter some specific information about this forest. In the ecology section, the main ecological zone is displayed. This is the one you selected at step one, the tropical dense forest. And here is the forest degradation rate. You can adjust it by moving the cursor along the horizontal bar. By clicking on settings, you will see that this degradation rate has a direct influence on carbon stocks and biodiversity. But you can delink the effects on carbon and biodiversity by amending them separately. The carbon data that appears here is from the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC, and it depends on the type of ecological zone chosen. In case of doubt, remember that you can always refer to the grey question marks that appear throughout the tool. They guide you at every step. And for more details, you can download the user manual. In the economy component, you will estimate the economic value of forest goods and services. These include timber, bushmeat, or the environmental services these forests provide. To help you, this drop-down menu allows you to use data already available for different types of forest. By clicking on Settings, you can then refine this data with your own knowledge of the area. For example, here, if you think this data does not reflect the conditions of the area, you can modify it. You can also change the distribution of benefits among economic actors for this land use. This is a forest concession. It may belong to a foreign investor, in which case you estimate that 80% of the costs and benefits go to the investor and that the local people in the state are not so involved. Click on Save and our first forest appears on the land use bar. And so on and so forth. This is how we describe our other categories of forests. Then we move on to the crop that was of interest to us, the oil palm. Here too, we look at our maps. If necessary, let's make a few more phone calls to our contacts in the field. And we'll drag a perennial crop icon to start. As we did for forests, we give it a name, industrial oil palm plantation, and enter its size, as estimated again from our map, 10,000 hectares. In the same way as we did for forests, you can use the drop-down menu to fill in the data before refining. In the economics section here, it will be important to accurately describe the yield profile of the oil palm trees, knowing that the age of the trees has a significant impact on yields, Do not hesitate to adjust all the data that appears: the age of the oldest plantations, the distribution of benefits among the beneficiaries, the average commodity price, the maximum yield, and you can also directly adjust the yield profile. Do not forget to enter the capital and labour cost data for this crop. You can also specify some ecological values related to these plantations. Click Save, and the oil palm plantations will appear in the land use bar. And so on. We add all the important land uses one after the other. You see here about 10 different uses. Some may even be superimposed, for example, livestock in a community forest. You can then modify these land uses. For example, if we want to amend some data related to our rice crop, we click here. We realise, for example, that we have forgotten to consider the importance of this crop for local food security. By clicking here, the tool allows you to indicate the calorie content of this crop. The results related to food security will be taken into account. In tropical regions, annual crops may also be coming from shifting cultivation. By clicking on Settings, you can consider this aspect for further calculations. Well, we come to a point where the snapshot of our area is pretty complete. Don't worry if there is some unallocated land. By default, the tool will consider this to be bare land, with no benefits or associated costs. One tip: be sure to check the data you have inputted with your partners and different actors. Invite them to refine your information, and don't forget to export a version of your working file before proceeding. We're ready to go on to the next step, which will project us into the future by defining scenarios.